Good morning, children. I am Ramya, your science teacher of Kakatiya Public School. Today again I am back with another new topic, movements and shelter in animals. Okay, we learned about the living and non-living things and its characteristic features, and based on that only we can decide whether the thing is a living or non-living. So the first thing of the first characteristic feature of living things is nothing but that it shows a movement. So in our class today we are going to discuss how the different animals will be moving from one place to another place. In last class, like animals and plants topic, we have learned that how do animals will be moving, for what purpose they will be moving from one place to another. So we are moving from one place to another, that means we are coming to school, going to home, other places, etc. Similarly, animals are also moving from one place to another, but for what purpose they are moving animals? For in search of food, water and shelter. Okay, so animals will be moving from one place to another place in search of food, water and shelter. So how they are moving, with which organs they are able to move, how the their legs and whatever it may be they are designed, in what way they are helping to move from one place to another place easily, that we are going to discuss in our class today. First of all, if you take example like different animals are having different organs which will be using to move from one place to another place. For like human beings, if we are using our legs, yes, to move from one place to another place, with the help of legs we are moving. Now, coming to the animals like cows, buffaloes, tigers, elephant, giraffe, number of animals, they are also using their legs to move, like for moving, like run, walk, okay? They will be moving like, they will be showing like movement like walking and running. So, first of all, coming to the cows, buffaloes, goat, etc. These kind of animals are having a special kind of feet called hoofed feet. That means if you observe the legs of these animals, they are having like a thick black color, thick substance on the feet. They are having the special feet called hoofed feet. That means it's a black in color and it's very thick. Why it is designed specially in this way? Because what happens, this will be helping them to move on any kind of, that will be helping them to move in any kind of land, even in a rocky places. Even in a rocky places. That means if there is not a good land, like there is not a good area, there also they can be walking very easily. This kind of feet, what we call it as hoofed feet. What feet? Hoofed feet. If you observe cows, buffaloes, they're having the very strong feet, and that will be helping to walk on any kind of land. And coming to the tigers, cheetah, lion, etc. These animals are having the padded feet. They are having the padded feet. If you observe the feet, if you see once a picture of any animals, if you observe the feet of that animal, what happens, it will be like padded feet. That padded feet will, and they are having the sharp nails or whatever it may be, they are having, and for what purpose they are having this kind of designed feet? Why? These are wild animals, they will be hunting. They will also be going in search of food, but what they will do? They will be hunting like other animals. They will be hunting the other animals. At that time, these feet will be helping. That means there is no sound while they are running to hunt any animal. These feet will do not make any sound. Silently, they will hunt the animals by using their feet. And it also helps in catching. That I covered in the food and feeding habits of animals. In that chapter, I told that they will be eating. They are carnivores. That means they will be eating the flesh of other animals. These feet will be helping them to tear the flesh, catch the flesh. They will be helping to hold the prey and tear the flesh and eat that. So in this way, that parrot feet are helping. Next, coming to the rabbits. Rabbits, hares, etc. They are having the four legs, like limbs we say. Front limbs and the back limbs. Front limbs and the hind limbs. Generally, front limbs and the back hind limbs. What they will do, they will be showing the what kind of movement. These all animals are running and walking. But rabbits, if you go for the rabbits and hares, what they will do, they will be showing the movement called jumping. They will jump or hop. That means these limbs, they are having the four limbs toward front and toward back. These two, that front limbs, two front limbs are very strong. They are strong. And the thin limbs, the back limbs which are there, they will be helping them to jump forward. They are long. Hind limbs are long and the front limbs are short. And front limbs are very strong. And hind limbs, with the help of hind limbs only, they are able to jump forward. If you observe the rabbit when it is moving, it will be showing like jumping or hopping movement. Yes, it will be like jumping. With what legs it is helping to jump? What legs are helping to jump for rabbit? That hind limbs, whatever the limbs which are present backside, they will be pressing the gland and they will be showing the movement. That means they are just jumping. And the stronger front limbs are landing on the land. In this way, rabbits and hares will be showing the next, snakes, snails, what kind of movement they will be showing? They will be crawling on the ground. They will show the crawling movement. Okay, they will be showing the crawling movement. You know very well about the snake, where it will be swimming on land and in water. But if you observe the snake, its movement, it do not have any legs, but it will be showing the crawling movement. Even earthworms also, they do not have any legs, no legs, but they will be showing the movement. What kind of movement? Crawling. Crawl. They just varying movement, that is nothing but the crawling. Next, coming to the fish. Fish, you know, everyone know that fish living in a water, and they too do not have the legs. Instead, they are having the fins. They are having the fins, and their body is very smooth, and also it is designed like a boat. With the help of these fins, and they are having a tail also. If you observe the this is a fish. If you observe the diagram of a fish, this is a body and these are the fins. This is a tail. With the help of the fins and the tail only, they will be showing the movement in the water. They can swim easily in the water, and their body is smooth, and it is designed as a boat. Designed as a boat shaped body, that's why they can swim easily in the water. And crocodiles also, they will be living on land, and most of them they will be living in the water. They are also having the paddles. Okay, with the help of their legs only, they will be swimming or walking on the land and in the water. And this is all about the animals. Like one more thing, birds. If you take birds, they do not have legs, but they do have legs, but only for some distance they will be walking. But most of them will be flying. They will be flying with the help of wings. And insects also having some wings, and they are also having the wings, and they will also be flying in the sky. So this is all about the different types of animals, which will be having different kinds of, showing different types of movements. Okay, next one is shelter. What is shelter? After finishing school, where you will be going? You will be going to the your home. Why you will be staying in the home? Because to protect yourself, right? To protect yourself from the heat, cold, rainfall, whatever it may be, and also from the enemies, we need a house. That means we will be protected by our house. That is nothing but the shelter. Similarly, animals also need shelter. Animals also need shelter. They also need shelter to protect them from, that means to grow young ones. They also need, like, for protection. They too need the shelter for protection, protecting them from enemies. So different animals will be living in different places. If you come to the wild animals like tiger, elephant, etc., they will be living in the forest, and they will be living in the bushes, like more trees. Wherever the more trees are present, there they will be living in the bushes in the forest. And coming to the snakes, earthworms, snails, etc., they will be living in the soil. They will be living in the soil, making the holes in the soil and living in the soil. And coming to the rabbit, they too will be living in the soil. They will make burrows. They will make burrows, and they will be living in the soil underground. So, and coming to the domestic animals like cow, buffalo, hen, dog, cat, etc., they will be living in some constructed places, like it is made by man. For example, cow and buffalo, they will be living in a shed, and hen, they will be living in a coop. Dog and cat, they will be having a kennel. So the designed shelter we call with the some names, and those are done by man. That means man-made things, like cow and buffalo shed, hen coop, dog and cat in the kennel, and horse stable. We call the place of living place of horse, like shelter of horse, we call it as a stable. And they are kept in their places. And what we have to do, what is our courtesy is to do, that we should protect them carefully. We should take care of them, because as they are helping us in number of ways, we have to take care of them. And whenever they are feeling like they are feeling ill or sick, we should immediately consult a doctor, like an animal doctor, veterinary doctor, and we should take care of them. And we should also provide the sufficient food and water to them where they are living. In this way, we have to take care of our animals, which are helping us in different ways. I hope you all understood the class. And with this video, I am also posting some pictures regarding this topic, so you can understand the class very easily. Okay, now I'll be giving worksheet. Here is a worksheet. How should we take care of our domestic animals? Lastly, I told about this, how we should take care of them. Now, next one is, how are padded feet useful to some animals? I told that like wild animals, tiger, lion, etc., they're having the padded feet while hunting. They'll be walking slowly. That means they won't make any noise while they're hunting. And also helping them to catch the prey and tail. Next, how do legs of rabbit help it to move about? Like rabbit will be showing the movement, it will jump or hopping. That is about these three question answers. Next, coming to the match the following, it's very simple. Here are the animal names and here are the shelters which they are living. So we have to match like cow, horse, dog, hen. For example, cow, they will be living in the shed. Horse, stable. Like that you have to match it. And I hope you will follow the worksheet. You will be doing the worksheet. And next I will be coming with another video. Okay, till that time, all the best. Bye.